The Pink Show is provided by Mission Grocery Outlet in San Francisco. Welcome to The Pink Show. Today I have so many good things for you. I have my tips, what's trending on social media. We're gonna check with Tammy Lee, my producer, what's going on in the Bay Area this weekend. And now let's check with Glayton Martins, who went to San Jose to talk with an artist who got inspired last year during COVID.
Many people feel that the pandemic was a loss of time, but not for Tulio Flores. The Latino artist based in San Jose used the time during the pandemic to focus and paint.
And I love it because I did a mural inside the house. I did two murals inside the house. I started like so many paintings.
His studio is located in his backyard, which makes it easier for him to chill and to paint after spending long hours at his tacky job.
And I miss this painting.
Besides mixing nature and humans, Tulio's style is rich, vibrant, and blends his Mexican roots with the American culture, as in the painting of Ruth Bader Ginsburg, a process that takes time.
2 weeks to figure out. The painting took me 2.5 months.
Once the ideas are connected, he still needs to give some fine tuning.
Like I do every single detail. Like it has to be the eye, it has to be perfect. The flowers have to be perfect. Kind of like what I did with this one. The birds are talking to each other or talking to her. So
each piece is unique and so is the price, which can go up to $5,000.
So that one is already sold.
Oh, this is already sold, yeah. But they haven't come and get it.
Tulio's creativity doesn't stop there. 3 years ago, he had an arts installation exhibition at the San Jose City College. Back at his home, two murals were painted during the pandemic.
You do the camera like this, it seems like it's moving.
And it certainly looks like the painting is moving.
And if you got inspired during last year during COVID, I want to know your story. So send me an email at thepinkshow@newsabout.org. And now let's check what's trending on social media. If you haven't noticed that Olivia Rodrigo is totally setting the world on fire with her debut album Sour, then you must be living under a rock. Sour is the first debut album by any singer to generate 2 Billboard Hot Number Ones. Driver's License was not only at the top of Billboard's Hot 100 when the song dropped earlier this year, but it also broke Spotify's record for the most song streams in a week. If you haven't heard Rodrigo's Driver's License or Good For You, get ready to bawl and rage in a span of minutes because her music allows you, the listener, to feel as deeply as she does. 18-year-old Olivia Rodrigo, star of the Disney Plus show High School Musical, the musical may be the voice of Gen Z, but she is the spirit of every millennial. Elliot Page, the actor from Juno and Umbrella Academy, is proudly celebrating his journey since coming out as transgender last December. In an interview with Oprah in May, Page opened up about his transition surgery, describing it as life-saving and how that led him to feel comfortable in his own body for the first time.
It's being able to touch my chest and feel comfortable in my body for probably the first time. Tears of joy.
Paige recently shared a milestone picture of his first bare-chested picture as well as his toned six-pack abs on Instagram and captured the post saying, "Trans BB's first pair of swim trunks." His post has garnered love and support from artists like Miley Cyrus, Oprah Winfrey, and co-star Nina Dobrev. Yes, they are officially man and wife. 5 months after announcing their engagement, Ariana Grande, the Thank You Next songstress, just posted a series of photos from her secret intimate at-home wedding to real estate agent Dalton Gomez earlier this month. In the photos, Grande is wearing a strapless lily-white Vera Wang dress with a veil atop her signature ponytail, and their home is decorated with candles and flower petals hanging from the ceiling. Grande and Gomez started dating in January 2020 and spent the pandemic social distancing in her LA home, and they got engaged later that year in December. And I'm here with my producer, Tammy Lee. Tammy, what do you got for us?
I have a little something for everyone. Carnival, the largest multicultural celebration on the West Coast, is back. The two-day celebration showcasing the very best in Latin American and Caribbean culture, arts, and traditions is now in its fourth decade. The festival, covering 17 blocks in the Mission District, will feature 5 main stages, 50 local performing artists, and 400 vendors, has been an opportunity for many to come together to celebrate and share in a weekend of global cuisine, international music, and dance. And the best part is, it's free. Here's something fun, different, and free to do. Every weekend from now through June 2021, you can experience Walkway Weekends in the heart of America's oldest Chinatown. San Francisco's iconic Grant Avenue will be closed off to traffic between California and Washington Streets so that you can enjoy a historic street stroll, grab a bite to eat, or shop under vibrant red lanterns. Ready to party 2020 away? AfroSoca, the largest multicultural celebration of love, is headed to Oakland this weekend, May 30th and 31st. Enjoy the good vibes of the community and soak in the culture. You'll get to experience amazing food and incredible DJs at a silent disco, so make sure you bring your dancing shoes. For more information, check out AfroSoca on TicketBud.com. A great way to end May is to eat great food with great people. Make sure to invite your friends and family out to Alameda as their Flavors of Alameda event comes to a close. Make sure to visit participating restaurants to support and collect points to win some prizes. To learn more about participating restaurants, go to flavorsofalameda.com.
Tammy, I definitely want to go to Alameda this weekend. How about you?
That one is a lot of fun. I've been to that in previous years, and the food is amazing there. You'll have to go.
So let's go.
Yes.
But before that, let's check some of my tips. Hi, I'm here at the Mission Grocery Outlet in San Francisco to put them to the test to see if they have good makeup products on a budget. So let's take a look. They have so many things that I get lost with how many good things, but one of the things that I love the most that they have is concealer. We cannot live without concealer, especially me with the dark circles that I have. I cannot live without a concealer. So I'm definitely grabbing a concealer. And there's another thing that I found that I need as well is powder. Everyone needs powder, right? So got my concealer, got my powder. Also, I need my mascara. Cannot live without a mascara as well when we do our makeup. And look at this, it's gonna make my eyelashes even longer and fuller. And the best part of it is waterproof. Can you see how big it gets? So I definitely love this baby. There's another thing that I found here that I really want is the stick foundation from Revlon. We all need some makeup. I love makeup. I cannot live without makeup, especially with a pink shell, but I like to shop smart. There's another thing that I found here that I thought that was so interesting that I never seen before, which is this one, skin clearing. With the masks that we're always wearing, we definitely need this one too. I hope you like my tips of the week. If you want to check it out, come to the Mission Grocery Outlet in San Francisco because they have good finds and amazing prices. And thank you so much for watching and follow us on social media. Give me your comments and your likes. And if you have any suggestions, please send us an email at thepinkshow@newsupnow.org. And I'll see you next week.